such a senior physician for so many years, and when the patient starts getting angry because he feels that someone was harmed because of an error which took place, how do you deal with that anger where he's upset with you, he's upset with the staff, he feels that, you know, you're not looking after my patient properly?
I think such occasions would be by and large few if you conduct yourself in a proper manner. I think the single most important thing in a patient-doctor relationship is that if you do not know what is happening to your patient, you should be able to tell him right from the start that I really do not know what the problem is and I'm trying to solve it as best as I can. If something goes wrong, for example, you have to explain to him why it has gone wrong, how it has gone wrong, and what we are doing to try and see if we can correct the wrong. It is, of course, primum non nocere, which means first of all, do no harm. But I think most of you here will remember there are situations when you want to do good and you apply a therapeutic principle in the hope that the patient is going to get well. And you know full well that it is possible that the same therapeutic principle or therapeutic line that you follow can do him harm. It's inescapable sometimes. It's important that you have first explained that to him. But it's not the patient really, you know, who is ultimately going to tell you what to do. There is, of course, the patient's right to be informed. All that is true. But ultimately, it is the doctor's decision that in this particular illness, if I use this particular method of treatment, I know it can do harm. And he has to balance the issue whether it's more likely to do good than harm. If I do not do it, maybe the patient will die. If I do it, maybe the patient will live, or he might even succumb to it. So this is a double effect, and it happens in medicine all the time. But you can be salvaged from a dreadful or a dangerous situation if you explain this to the patient. Therefore, communication here is extremely important, and patient consent